Hello everyone, this is Shafiq from Knowledge Byte channel. Today we are going to see at another episode on Microsoft Excel. Here we are going to see on page layout option. Page layout is nothing but setting the page margins and the page setup, etc. See, when you're typing any data in Microsoft Excel, randomly, for example, I'm typing some data over here. Maybe I'll just a little bit increase the font size so that it will be easy for you. Here what I'm doing is I'm typing some data over here in Microsoft Excel. The problem with Microsoft Excel is when you're in a spreadsheet, you won't be able to see the page numbers, or you won't be able to clearly identify where the page starts and where the first page gets over. For that reason only, we need to use this page layout option. Here you can see your page setup. There is a separate ribbon available, that is page setup. Inside that you can see so many tools are there. In case, first thing what you have to do is you have to set the paper size. So it depends on the type of paper which you want to use, where you want to take the printout. Usually by default we used to take printout in A4 sheet paper. So the option will be clicked as A4. Or in case if you want to change the size, maybe letter size paper or legal size paper, what you can just do is you can click on that. So depending upon that, automatically it will adjust the paper size. And once you click the paper size, you can see here there is a dotted line which appears. So in this dotted line will be able to help you to identify the exact page range. So you can see here up to row number 27 and G column, the first page ends and again the second page starts here. It depends on how you are typing. If you're typing below also, that will be considered as the second page. Or if you start continuously typing this side, means this will become the second page. Right side will become the... So it depends on the way you're typing things. So this, we have already set the page size. Then you have to select the orientation. If you are typing in the form of portrait, where you want, usually normally when we are typing any documents, we used to take printout in portrait form. But if you want to take printout in landscape format, then you can select as landscape. So depending upon that, the width and height will change and the page setup will also change. So you can see here automatically the column have been moved to J and row has been reduced now because it is in landscape format. So only till 18th row is considered as the first page. So it depends on what type you want. Then there is something called, this is an important feature, margins. So by default, one normal margin will be there. In case if you want to narrow it down, I mean you want to reduce the left and right margin or top and bottom margin, means you have to select narrow option. So you can have a glimpse of it when you see the print preview. When you press Ctrl P, you can see the glimpse of it when you're seeing. The same way, normal means normal margin setup will be there. If you want to set your own margin, means you should go to custom margins option. Here you can change the values. Okay, now for a better case, in case when you're typing some data over here in the form of table, you're typing something, let me even show you one sample. So like some data is there. Now when you go and see in print preview, it will appear like this. So this thing which is there, the table, it is somewhere near the center or it's somewhere near the right side. That's because I have not typed anything in the first two columns, so that will be considered as empty. When I'm typing it, that will also be visible. Now exactly I want these data to appear at the center, then what you can just do is go to page layout, margins, custom margins option. Here you will have something called center on page. If you click horizontally, so from horizontally exactly where the center of the page is there, based on that it will move, the data will move. If you click vertically, depending upon, you can see here in the preview, from top it will move to the center of the page. It depends on your wish. So if you click OK, now when you go and see the preview, exactly where the center it should be, it will move. Or for example, the same data, if you would have typed like this here, now it should be by default appear on the left hand side, okay, but when you click this center on page horizontally and center of page vertically, you can see here both the datas are shifting. In case if I'm deleting these datas, then it will be clearly visible. You can see here, so it will move accordingly. Then you have something called print area. Print area is nothing but by default when you're trying to go and see the preview, it will print everything, okay, whatever you are selecting, I mean whatever you have typed. But if I want to select a specific data and I want to only print these data, means you have to select and click set print area. So when you go and see in the preview, only that data will appear. Now you can see even the page layout has been applied because I have selected only these data. So for these data alone, whatever the margin is required, everything will be applied. So if you move vertically option, you can see here vertically will move, only horizontal center will be applied. So when you select print area option, it will help you to take print out of only those data which I have selected. Then there's something called page break. Page break when we will use means in case if I want to divide the pages. Now in case print area is not given, imagine I'm clearing the print area, so it will be like a default one. So as per the default, up to row number 27 is the first page, but I want to split these pages again into two, means what I can just do is I can go to break and I can click insert page break option. Now you can see here even in row 20, one more dotted line, you can see that indicates that that page has been divided into further parts, or it's been splitted into further parts. So that's how you can split the pages. Then this is just a important feature, not much important feature. In case if you want to give any background or a watermark, then you can go to background, you can select any picture, you can take from the pictures which you have in your computer by clicking work offline option, or you can, if you have internet connection, you can download from online also, and you can, when you use that option in the background, you will see pictures everywhere. Then print titles. Usually when you are taking print out, only the datas will come. These ABCD, this column names and these row names 1, 2, 3, 4, these will not come in the printout. But if I want those titles also to appear while taking printout, means then you should use print titles option. And then here you should click OK. And print titles. Then here lot of options will be there. In case for example, if you want to take printout of ABCD and 1, 2, 3, as I said, you should click on row and column headings option and click OK. And when you go and see the print, you can see here the print preview along with row and column names that will come. In case imagine if you have typed a huge data where this title which you have given in the table, that should appear in every page like that if you want, then you should go to print titles, you should select rows to repeat at top option, then you should select that row. So when you select that row in every page, you will see that row will appear. Like if you go to second page, in second page I have not typed this, but still you can see the rows will appear. So if you want specific row to get repeated in the different page, in all the pages, then you should use that option, rows to repeat at top. The same way, a specific column, if you want to appear it in all the pages, then you should use columns to repeat at left and select a specific column, click OK. When you go to print preview option, you can see here the second page also that particular column data will appear. So that's how you should use this columns to repeat at left and rows to repeat at top. Then if you want grid lines also to appear in printout, means you should select grid line, and you can see now even the grid lines will also appear in the printout. Before, it doesn't used to appear. Only whatever the data which we used to type, that will appear. But after selecting this option, even the grid lines by default, which was there in the spreadsheet, that will also come in the form of printout. So I hope you guys have enjoyed today's session. So stay safe at home. We'll meet you in the next session. Thank you. Bye-bye.